Insight on BCTV is supported by the Vision Resource Center.
If you face blindness and it starts to seem as though your eyes are only good for crying and you're feeling all alone, come to a place of kindness and in a new way you will see that there's much more to hope than just learning to cope. You can live a life that's full and free where the Vision Resource Center, let us be your guiding light. As we strive to keep your dreams alive, even if you lose your sight, you're not alone, pick up the phone, we help friends and family too. We're the Vision Resource Center for people affected by blindness and low vision. We're here for you.
April 2022 episode of Insight here on BCTV. We'd like to welcome all of our viewers and thank you for joining us once again. We'd also like to welcome our guest. We have Chris Kaag joining us. He is the founder and CEO of the I Am Able Foundation. So my name is Mark Levengood. I'm the counselor at the Vision Resource Center of Berks County. And our topic for you today is indeed discussing the I Am Able Foundation. So good morning, Chris. How are you today?
I'm doing well, Mark. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for joining us. And if you could just start us off by sharing, what is the I Am Able Foundation?
The I Am Able Foundation was the nonprofit I started back in 2007, trying to give people the opportunity to be as active as possible, providing adaptive equipment grants and giving them the tools that's going to provide them the ability to get out and be as active as possible.
Awesome. So where is it located and what year did you say it started?
We are in Wyomissing and I started in 2007.
Awesome. And then what is the mission and the vision of the I Am Able Foundation?
Creating an environment that everybody is able, everybody is equal. You know, everybody's going to have the same ability to get out and lead the most active and fulfilling life as possible. And unfortunately, for those in the disabled community, know it's not cheap to be disabled. So, you know, providing those tools to be able to provide them the opportunity to get out and be as active as possible is something that we pride ourselves on, giving people those opportunities.
That's awesome. What was the inspiration and kind of the impetus behind the start of this great foundation?
Well, I am actually adaptive as well. And I had been, started riding hand cycles probably about, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, and just realized, how expensive everything is. And I was at my doctor for my condition down at Kennedy Krieger down in Baltimore. And this was Children's Hospital. And, I'm going in there, I was walking at the time, but I was starting to limp a little bit, but I was seeing kids with breathing tubes, feeding tubes, confined to chairs, confined to beds. And I was very lucky to have a normal childhood, and these kids are not going to have that same opportunity. So I really just got the idea that I wanted to provide them the tools to be able to provide them a somewhat normal childhood as best I could.
That's wonderful. So as the founder and CEO of the I Am Able Foundation, could you share with us, what are some of your roles and responsibilities?
Do we have all day to talk about this? I love being involved in everything. It's something that's very rewarding for me to be able to see the impact that I Am Able has had over the past 15 years. And I'm very involved in pretty much all the stuff. I have a great team. I have a COO and I have a director of development, and it's great that, I have those people who are in place to be able to make those things happen, but I still am very involved with all the people that we serve, because I just have fun doing it. It's like, it's very rewarding.
Sure. Yeah. And that was my next question. Like, how much interaction and involvement do you have with those receiving services from the I'm Able Foundation? Because I think a lot of times, or at least stereotypically, you know, the people at the very, very top might be disconnected from the people who are actually the beneficiaries. So, but it sounds like you're pretty involved.
Very involved. We're still a small grassroots nonprofit. So, you know, I'm not some big corporation. I don't have a team of 100 people. So I have not gotten disconnected, nor do I ever plan on, because I definitely like to do the work. I definitely like being involved in as much as possible. But at the same time, I really want to be able to rely on my team, because I have some amazing teammates who are going to make some incredible things happen.
Awesome. Has anyone from the visually impaired community ever come to the I Am Able Foundation to receive services?
Receive services, but we have, so we do a triathlon. So my Got the Nerve triathlon was the first endeavor I started back in 2004. And we've become the adaptive race around Pennsylvania. And, you know, we have visually impaired that do, you know, participate in my triathlon. So we team them up with guides to be able to make sure that they can run with them, swim with them, bike with them. I mean, I have a young man from Pittsburgh who's a stud, and it's like, it's great that we actually had the ability to have a visually impaired, you know, athlete that was participating with us. Cause I think it was something that was really, really profound for all of us to be able to see that, you know, we're able to serve pretty much everybody.
Absolutely. And prior to that, you know, starting up the triathlon, what was the extent of your interactions working with the visually impaired or interacting with the visually impaired in general?
Honestly, I have not known a lot of visually impaired. That's something that when I go out and speak, you know, there's a lot of people who never dealt with somebody with a disability. And that's something I really want to make sure that, you know, gets talked about. So I love learning more about the visually impaired, because, you know, we actually had a team from Alvernia who did a dinner with a blindfold on, and that was very impactful for me. I mean, I'm disabled, but at the same time, I have my sight. And when I was there at that dinner, that was a pretty profound, you know, night that I think that it's good for us to be able to learn more about all kinds of different disabilities.
Sure. Yeah. And I know when the Vision Resource Center holds our annual Dine in the Dark every October, you know, we hear the same response from the participants when they go under the blindfold and have to endure a meal without vision, even just for that 30 to 45 minutes. It is a profound experience for a lot of people, as you said.
Yeah, I think that it's an incredible opportunity for people to be able to, you know, be in the shoes of somebody who's visually impaired. And, you know, that was a pretty impactful night.
Yeah. Is the I Am Able Foundation specific to Berks County, or do other states and counties have something similar?
We are always building, man. We're trying to make this as big as possible. So right now, we serve the Mid-Atlantic region. So we accept grants from, you know, states around Pennsylvania to be able to provide, you know, the adaptive equipment grants. But we're in Berks County. So for the, like the I Am Fit, so, you know, I Am Able started by providing adaptive equipment grants, but we've also now expanded to programming. So we have programs that serve the adaptive, cognitively or, you know, emotionally challenged, you know, population. So that's really around here, but that's something that I see we're going to be able to take even farther, because there's nobody doing the things that we're doing. And there's a lot of communities who are in need of the types of services that we're offering.
Sure. That's wonderful. So what are the physical requirements as well as the age requirements that would allow someone to qualify and be eligible for help, support, and services with the I Am Able Foundation?
To be honest, man, I really don't think that there's any requirements. I mean, I really want to serve anybody. You know, I get so excited to see differences all the time of different, you know, different abilities coming in. And I love the challenge of figuring out how we're going to make this happen to serve them. So, you know, really, you know, there's really no age requirement. There's really no, you know, age, you know, that we don't serve. So, and the requirements simply people who are open-minded. People, you know, we definitely, you know, provide an environment that's motivating, encouraging, you know, just like I did for my able-bodied community when I had my gym. You know, we do the same sort of thing with our adaptive community. And for people who are just, you know, looking for a social atmosphere, for a place that they can, you know, team up with other, you know, like individuals and be as active as possible. If they're open-minded to it, they're going to have a great time.
That's awesome. I like that. The biggest requirement is open-mindedness. You know, beyond anything else, that's really all that matters.
Yep. Yep. There's not much difference about the adaptive community compared to the able-bodied community. It's just simply we have to figure things out. We have to just do things a little bit differently. But once you figure it out, it's really everybody has the same goals. Everybody has the same, you know, accomplishments, and they feel that rewarding, you know, regardless of you're disabled or not.
Absolutely. Chris, could you explain for us what the help, support, and services that the I Am Able Foundation actually provides? Like, what does it look like?
So again, one of our biggest, you know, things that we started is just providing adaptive equipment grants. So somebody who's physically, you know, challenged, they can, you know, get provided a hand cycle. So provide them a bike to get out and ride with their arms instead of their legs. You know, that's one of the biggest things that we do. But then the fitness. So I owned a gym for 16 years. I'm very, very big about being as active as possible. And, you know, now we provide that same opportunity for the cognitively challenged. So at our gym, you know, we provide the environment that's going to be able to accommodate anybody who has different differences to be able to achieve that they can be as active as possible. But, you know, aside from that, it's just, you know, being a resource for Berks County, making sure that people know if they have a disability or if they have, you know, different challenges, that we're here to be able to provide those services and provide those opportunities for them. And we're always learning. We're always, learning things and, you know, trying to provide different opportunities to everybody.
Excellent. And how do you and the I Am Able Foundation as a whole structure meeting the needs of the people, you know, and serving them as they need, considering their varying ages and their varying abilities versus impairments?
I'm not sure if I understand that question.
Okay, so like how do you structure the use of your employees, the use of your resources to make sure everyone's needs are being met based upon their situation, especially like, for example, here at the VRC, we know everybody has that common denominator of vision loss. But it sounds like you guys have such a wide array of people that you're looking to serve. You know, how do you begin to make sure everyone's needs are covered with your employees and your resources?
You know, once again, I think it's being open-minded, you know, and relying on our resources, relying on people like you. If we, you know, get somebody who comes in who's visually impaired, hey, I know Mark, I'm gonna talk to him about this. So we rely on our community. We rely on people who have the experience. If we are not sure about that, then we make sure that we reach out to the people who do so that we can, you know, serve people better.
Okay. And how can people begin receiving help and services from the I Am Able Foundation? I mean, do they contact you directly, or is a referral needed from like another local agency such as the VRC, or maybe even from a doctor?
No. So our programs that we run, so it's called I Am Fit. This is the fitness classes that we provide for our, you know, for our youth, you know, or cognitively challenged and things like that. And they're actually free. And that's something that, you know, we don't charge any of these parents. They have a challenge already, you know, on a daily basis of all the things that they have to provide their kids. So we provide it for free. And this is all provided by our sponsors, all the people who support I Am Able. So really the simple answer to this is simply reach out to us and get the process started.
Awesome. And then how and where are the I Am Able services provided? I mean, it sounds like everybody needs something different. So, you know, how and where does this take place?
So, you know, our facility is in Wyomissing, but we, you know, like we're going to do with you guys, we're doing a walk. So, you know, it's going to be utilizing different outdoor locations in Berks County that we're going to be able to provide those services. So it just depends on, you know, what it is that people are looking for.
Okay. And I know a minute ago you said the I Am Fit program. Is that what you said? that you said that one has no financial component to it, but what about the other services provided by I Am Able Foundation? What are the financial requirements or financial costs to those looking to receive services? Is there anything?
No, not really. So, you know, all the adaptive equipment grants that we provide, you know, people submit a grant and, you know, we base it on their income, their family, and, you know, their need. Some people we provide 80%, you know, coverage for the pieces of equipment, or we just received a grant from Move United this past Friday. We were able to buy, you know, six new pieces of adaptive equipment. It just depends on the need that people have. They can submit it, and then just depends on where we're at that time. You know, if we have the funding, if it's still in our budget, then we can provide those services for people for free.
Excellent. Because yeah, like you said earlier, anyone with a limitation or an impairment knows it's an expensive undertaking from just to function in day-to-day life. So that's wonderful. That's wonderful. Does the I Am Able Foundation ever partner with other local agencies or organizations to better assist those who are in need? And if so, could you give some examples of this?
To be honest, I mean, with the pandemic, I think that there's a lot of things that we could have done a lot better. But now we're starting to reinvigorate ourselves and trying to get out there. I'm always looking to collaborate with as many people as possible, because you know what? There's so many organizations that are doing great things, and each of us by ourselves are not going to accomplish as much unless we come together and work together as a group. So I'm always looking for different organizations, just like Vision Resource Center, you know, to be able to team up with you guys, to be able to provide something. I think this is an amazing opportunity. So you're one of my examples.
Well, thank you for that. You know, and I will say, I think COVID threw the whole world for a loop. I think we all tried to figure out how to work our way through that for sure. So. And Chris, what is Operation Lead from the Front? Could you share how this idea started and what you're hoping to accomplish through it?
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm a Marine, and you know, this is something that I think that veterans in general, you know, have a mission that they want to have, and this is something that I got this idea right before the pandemic started. I met with a friend of mine who is actually a Marine himself. He's been battling PTSD for probably about 4 or 5 years. He was getting ready to leave the Reading Phillies game. And I told him, hey, come out on Tuesday to an IM Fit class. I brought him out and I introduced him to Robert. Robert's a young man who suffers from spina bifida, walks with a walker. And I told Alan, it's your responsibility to train Robert, get it done. And so I just provided them the opportunity to get together, and Alan trained Robert. Robert, you know, this young man, he was 15 years old at the time. He's being trained by a Marine. I mean, it was something that was a win-win for both. And this is something that I think that can very easily be replicated all over the place, because there's so many veterans out there that, you know, definitely, you know, want a mission. They want something that's, you know, useful or something that's resourceful. And I think that this opportunity is going to be great for as many people as possible. So for you, like, you know, with our walk, I want to try to get as many veterans as I can to provide an elbow, you know, just to provide that opportunity for them to get out there and serve, and to provide that, you know, that tool for other people to be able to benefit from.
Yeah. Cause then, you know, obviously, retired veterans, you know, that they are all about having missions and having a task to do and looking to serve, and, you know, very selfless individuals. And so this gives them an opportunity to serve. And then, of course, there's a lot of people like Robert or like the visually impaired community, you know, that are in need of assistance. So it's like just bringing the two together is a perfect match.
Right. And, you know, to be honest, the whole start of this was because, you know what, I have my daily challenges. I'm in a chair, you know, I have, you know, problems with my legs, and, you know, on a daily basis, I have my challenges. I have things that I have to contend with, but you know what, I really forget a lot of that stuff, because, you know what, I have a lot of people who are depending on Chris Kaag to be able to motivate them and inspire them. And, you know, when I see the smiles on people's faces, and I love being around people. So, you know what, if I had a bad morning, it does not exist, because now I have a chance to be around some amazing people and provide those services that are going to, you know, help their day.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Are certain experiences and qualifications required for people looking to serve with you and serve with the I Am Able Foundation, whether it's veterans or other people? Like, do they have to have certain experience and qualifications to be eligible?
No. I mean, we generally do a background check, just, you know, the mm-hmm. child abuse and things like that. But no, again, I think there's a lot of people who may not have ever really dealt with the population that we serve. So, mm-hmm. it's so great to be able to see the volunteers, you know, the smiles and the fulfilling feeling that they get when they, you know, when they're helping our population. It's something that's, you know, pretty amazing to see the effect that they get. So it's kind of a mm-hmm. win-win. You know, they're helping our population, but at the same time, that population is definitely helping our volunteers as well.
Yeah, excellent. And Chris, as we begin to close, if anyone would like to learn more about the I Am Able Foundation, either to begin receiving services themselves, to partner with you and your team, or, you know, just to learn how to serve alongside of you, where should they go? Who should they contact and how?
So please contact www.im. So it's not IAM, it's the letter M for I Am Able, and then mm-hmm. ablefoundation.org. And, you know, there's a, you know, a way to contact us via email on there, you know, just the info, the general, the, you know, the people can reach out and contact any of us, and we'd be happy to get this process started.
Awesome. That is wonderful. So www.imable.org and www.imablefoundation.org.
Correct.
Okay. And then the IM is the letter I, the letter M, no A.
Correct.
So. Okay, perfect. Well, Chris, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Thank you for giving us part of your day, and especially thank you for what you and the I Am Able Foundation are looking to do to obviously empower a lot of people and you know, give others the opportunities that they might not be able to have otherwise. It's wonderful, and we really appreciate all that you and your team are doing.
Great. Thank you so much, Mark. I appreciate you getting me on here and getting on your platform. And I look forward to, you know, empowering and motivating more people. So anybody who's interested in getting a hold of us, please don't hesitate to reach out.
Awesome. Thank you. And to our viewers, we do hope that you enjoyed the program. And again, if I Am Able Foundation is something that would benefit you or a friend or a loved one, you know, just go to the website, like Chris said, www.iamablefoundation.org, and then go through the necessary channels from there. Just so everyone is aware, coming up for us here at the VRC on April 20th, the Vision Resource Center is partnering with the I Am Able Foundation to do Operation Lead from the Front with our clients and the veterans. And then on April 27th, we have our monthly sight loss support group. And actually on April the 9th, we are going to return to offering our annual Talking Easter Egg Hunt for the visually impaired kids of Berks County. So if anyone would like to know more about those upcoming activities, just contact me, Mark Levengood, at 610-375-8407, extension 120. And with that, we thank you so much for joining us. Hope you have a great day and month, and we hope to see you in May.
Insight on BCTV is supported by the Vision Resource Center.